So in this video, I'm going to talk about the L over R time constant, or the inductor-resistor time constant. To illustrate the L over R time constant, I'm going to draw a simple circuit involving only three circuit elements, a voltage source, an inductor, and a resistor. And we'll imagine that we also have a switch. At time t equals zero, I'm going to turn on the switch. Let me now label the voltages and currents in the circuit. What I want to do here is to find the voltage across the inductor as a function of time. So this is the goal of this video. To do that, I can start with Ohm's law, V equals IR. I also know how voltage and current are related in an inductor. And finally, I know how the voltages in the circuit are related because of the Kirchhoff voltage loop. So we have three equations, and this is enough information to fully solve the problem. So continuing here from the third, I can rewrite it as V equals VDC minus IR, substituting in from the first equation. Now I have two equations remaining and two unknowns, V and I, with respect to time. If I substitute the second equation, then I have L di over dt equals, and then I can write the rest of it. So finally, I have an equation where the only variable with respect to time is I. Since I have only one unknown in this equation, it's actually possible to find I with respect to time, but it's a first order differential equation. So it's not always easy just to look at the equation and say, oh, I know how to solve it. I know what the answer is, but in fact, that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to write the solution because differential equations in general do not have a method of solving them. However, the solution is usually easy to verify. So I'm going to write the solution here, and I is on the left side. We have no variables on the right side. Everything is constant except for time. So this is really an equation of the current through the circuit with respect to time. At time t equals zero, there's no current flowing. I would encourage you at this moment to pause the video and verify yourself that the solution is indeed correct for the equation. Take the derivative of I with respect to time, plug it into this equation, and then also plug I into the equation and show that it's all consistent. If we want to find the voltage with respect to time, we can just plug it into this equation. V then equals, after some simplification, VDC e to the minus t over L over R. And if I graph that, then I just get exponential decay. It makes a lot of sense if we look back at the circuit diagram and we think about what happens when the switch is thrown. You see, initially, there's no current flowing. And in fact, an inductor typically resists changes in current. It's difficult to change the current instantaneously through an inductor. So at time t equals to zero, the current flow is very, very small, and it rises and it rises and it rises. And finally, the current flow reaches its maximum value of V sub R divided by R. Once the current has reached its steady state value, then the current's not changing anymore. And because of the way the inductor behaves, then the voltage across the inductor should be zero because V is connected to di over dt. So if the current's not changing, there's no voltage. If there's no voltage, then we have only a constant magnetic field in the inductor. And you can also see in the graph here that as t approaches infinity, then the voltage across the inductor approaches zero. So the reason why the video is called the L over R time constant is because in the equation for exponential decay, you can see that time is divided by L over R. And if time is in units of seconds, then L over R also has to be in units of seconds. And it turns out that indeed, Henry's divided by ohms is the SI unit of second. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.